It's pretty much universally agreed that ApoB is a better metric, a better reflection of your risk of heart disease than LDL cholesterol. But it's kind of a drag. You got to go out and get another test. And a lot of you guys shared that you asked your doctor for the ApoB test. Some doctors don't want to request it. So there is another way. There is a formula that you can estimate your ApoB using the lipid panel that you already have. No more needles and no more money spent. It's this: 0.65 times your total cholesterol minus 0.59 times your HDL cholesterol plus 0.01 times your triglycerides. This formula gives you a pretty good approximation of your ApoB. There's a study that looked at many different formulas to try to estimate, and this one beat most of the others. So it gives you the closest estimation of your ApoB reading. There is one little caveat. If your triglycerides are very high, over 270, this is milligrams per deciliter, then you're better off using this slightly changed formula. 25.6 plus 0.58 times your total cholesterol minus 0.38 times your HDL cholesterol minus 0.06 times your triglycerides. So that's pretty convenient. Is it exactly the same as measuring? No, but it's a pretty good approximation. If you don't have an ApoB reading, if it's going to be a few months, or if you can't get one, your doctor won't request it, this is pretty good. It's better than not measuring. Another good alternative is the non-HDL cholesterol. Take your total cholesterol minus HDL cholesterol, and that number gives you an approximation, a pretty good replacement for ApoB, also a good metric to estimate risk of heart disease.